sounded mighty pretty. I'm just going to have to hire y'all to come on the road with me. Oh my, let's see here. Well, I'm going to do a lot of Merle Travis stuff, but I want to do something by a couple other people who I really admire and that Merle inspired to become performers. One of those was a fella by the name of Jerry Hubbard, J.R. Hubbard, known to many as Jerry Reed. Grew up listening to Merle Travis on the radio on the Grand Ole Opry and said, I gotta be able to play like that, son. So that's just what he did. He wrote a song that I feel is very true in today's society just as much as it was back then. One of them millions of Americans who owns one of them gas, drinking, piston, clanking, smoke, belching, air polluting, horseless buggies comes out of Detroit City, then pay attention. I'm about to sing your song, son. Well, I'm not a man to point or judge, third wheel or hold a grudge, but I think it's time to send me a few choice words. Learn about that demon automobile, the metal monster with the polyglass wheels, the end result of the dream of Henry Ford. Well, I got a car that's mine alone and made by the finest company owned. It's a ready-made pile of manufactured grief. If I ain't out of gas in the pouring rain, I'm changing a flat in a hurricane. I once spent 3 days lost on clover leaf. Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, say your contribution, man, say the least, got a little out of hand. Well, Lord, Mr. Ford, what have you done? Well, the average American father and mother owns one whole car and a half another. I'm sure that half a car's a trick to drive, don't you? But the thing that amazes me, I guess, is the way we measure a man's success by the kind of automobile he can afford to buy. Well, red light, green light, traffic cop, no turn right, turn must turn stop. Pull out the credit card, honey, we're out of gas. Well, all the cars reached end to end will reach to the moon and back again, and there'd probably be some poor fool pull out to pass. Well, now how I yearn for the good old days without that carbon dioxide haze hanging over the roar of the interstate. Cause if the Lord that made the moon and stars had meant for me and you to have cars, he'd make sure we was all born with a parking space. Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, they say your contribution to man, say the least, got a little out of hand. Well, Lord, Mr. Ford, what have you done? I'm asking, Lord, Mr. Ford, what have you done?